Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In the last video we learn about water pollution. In the classification of water pollutant we have learned in detail what are organic pollutants. In today lecture we will learn about inorganic pollutants. Let's see what is inorganic pollutant. This category of inorganic pollutant consists of inorganic salts, mineral acids, final divided metals, heavy metals or metal complexes. These are the various sources through which the substances enter natural water bodies. Here you can see the sources of inorganic pollutant. Mostly the acidity of water increases due to industrial discharge of waste. Similarly, chemical waste and agriculture waste increases the percentage of nitrate and phosphate which are found in storm water. And the major source of heavy metals are industries, motor vehicles and acid mine drainage. These are the major sources of inorganic water pollutant. So let's see first acid mine drainage. It is similar to acid rain. It is due to action of bacteria on metal compound. Acid mine result from the presence of sulfuric acid produced during oxidation of pyrite. In this diagram you can see the color of water is changes because of this acid mine drainage. In the oxidation of pyrite, different type of reaction, several reaction are take place. We will see one by one. First step is the oxidation of pyrite. Pyrite first get oxidized into Fe2+. In the second step, oxidation of Fe2+ to Fe3+ take place. Here you can see Fe2+ is get oxidized to Fe3+. These oxidation steps take place very slowly. At below pH 3.5, oxidation is catalyzed by ion bacterium thiobacillus ferrooxidans. And in the range of 3.5 to 4.5, oxidation is catalyzed by different metallogenium. Here you can see metallogenium. pH is shown. If pH is below 3.5, then oxidation is catalyzed by ion bacterium thiobacillus ferrooxidans. If pH is in the range of 3.5 to 4.5, the oxidation is catalyzed by variety of metallogenium. The Fe3+ ion form in the step second, it dissolves more pyrite. Here you can see this Fe3+ dissolves this pyrite. Here you can see the H+ ion is generating, means the acidity is goes on increasing. Then this Fe3+ react with water to form precipitate of FeOH thrice, or you can say hexa aqua ion, and to which mainly acid mine drainage take place, which increases the acidity of water, and this acidic water is toxic to aquatic ecosystem. Again you can see in the acid mine drainage, first step is the oxidation of pyrite, in which pyrite get oxidized to Fe2+. In the second stage, oxidation of this Fe2+ to Fe3+ is take place. This oxidation is catalyzed by different bacterium depend on the pH value. If pH is below 3.5, then oxidation is catalyzed by iron bacterium Thiobacillus ferrooxidase. If pH is in the range of 3.25 to 4.5, then it is catalyzed by metallogenium. The Fe3+ is generated. It dissolves more pyrites, and after dissolves more pyrite, it increases the acidity of water, which is very toxic to our aquatic ecosystem. And therefore, the prevention and cure of acid mine water is major challenge for the environmental chemists. Here in the figure, you can see the color of the water is changing drastically. It is the red color it is showing in the picture. Next one in our pollutants are heavy metals. These are the most harmful elemental pollutants and are more dangerous to human. And these elements are mostly transition elements. Let's see some of the examples of inorganic pollutant. If the percentage of nitrates increases in water, it causes blue baby syndrome, stomach cancers, this type of diseases due to increase in percentage of nitrate. Second one is a mercury. If the percentage of mercury in water, the elemental mercury is not harmful, but if this mercury is in the form of methyl mercury, it causes Minamata disease. All of we know that the Minamata diseases is occur through the fish to the human beings. Next is a mercury. Mercury in the form of methyl mercury causes Minamata diseases. Actually, elemental mercury is not harmful, but if it is in the form of methyl mercury, it causes a free radical chain reaction, and therefore it is very harmful and causes Minamata disease. Next one is a cadmium. Increase in percentage of cadmium, it causes eti disease. It also damages to the liver and kidney. It is very harmful element. Next one is arsenic. Increase in percentage of arsenic, it's very poisonous. It can cause cramps, paralysis and even death. So the concentration of this element should not exceed. Next one is fluoride. As the range of fluoride, it is in the range of 1 milligram per liter. If the concentration of this fluoride is increases, it causes mottling of teeth enamel, nervous and skeleton disorder. Remember, the concentration of fluoride is in the range of 1 milligram per liter only. Second heavy metal is lead. It causes loss of appetite, constipation, abdominal pain, nervous disorder and brain damage. I have taken only some of the example. There are many more. The increase in percentage of heavy metals or elements causes severe effect to the human health as well as aquatic ecosystem also. Next inorganic pollutant is sediments. Sediments are nothing but the layers of relatively finely divided matter. In the diagram, you can see the low level of sediment passes the sunlight through the water to the aquatic ecosystem. When there is increase in strength of sediment, the sunlight is not passes to the ecosystem. These sediments consist of mixture of fine medium and coarse grain materials. These are nothing but the clay, slit, etc. The proportion of these sediments is not fixed. They are under the bottom of the water. The physical, chemical and biological process result in deposition of sediment in the regions of bodies of sediments in the bottom region of water. Main drawback of these sediments is, here you can see again, when the level of sediment is low, the sunlight is passes through the water. Therefore, the growth of the plant under the water is balancing, which is the food of the fish. When this level of sediment is high, then the sunlight is not passes through the water to this algae, you can say, then which affects the food of fish, and that means it disturbs our aquatic ecosystem. In this way, today we learn inorganic pollutant. It mainly covers acid mine drainage, heavy metals and sediments. In the next video, we will learn about the pesticides and detergent. Thank you for watching this video.